Hello everyone and welcome back to my career mode playthrough in Juno New Origins. We are in version 1.0.4.0 and I'm itching to send something to one of our moons, or at least a heavier payload than a CubeSat. So let's see what career has to offer here. Luna flyby. Okay, wow, wait, 250 million? Isn't that a wild escalation? I mean, we've got 9 million. Well, this is sort of how real-life contracts work, though. Sometimes a small rocket company, which has an 8-ton rocket right now, that's our current rocket here. I guess one of these. Launch new craft, start grounded, be in Luna's SOI. That's it? I think we can do that with our current rocket, with $413,000 price tag. There might be other costs going forward, though, so we shouldn't take this lightly. I mean, I thought we were rolling in dough because our rockets were costing like $10,000 each, and then suddenly we went up to $400,000, so you never know. This CubeSat mission, of course, doesn't interest me anymore. It's small. We need, like, bigger satellites or something to launch instead of a CubeSat. So, yeah, I'll just take this. Alright, I might want to keep an eye... Well, I might want to keep an eye on this one. This one doesn't run out, though. But we haven't really done the vehicles, the land vehicles or planes. And I might actually want to do a tutorial on that one. Yeah, we could do that. And there's still fireworks, but I don't know. We haven't really progressed in days very much. It's 29.8 days. So we've only used 0.2 days since this contract was originally offered. So, yeah, we've got time, I guess. But then again, if we're going to the moon, it's gonna take some time. So that might be a thing. Okay, we've got an advance of 59 million. I already spent my tech tree points. And let's just remind ourselves how that looks right now. So, we've got RCS if we need it, but I don't think we need it for this one. We've got full solid boosters and cone nozzles and various greens for the boosters, and we got the new contracts. Yeah, and bearings, well, might want to make use of that, but in this case, well, we'll use the fairing at the top instead of the cone, just for future uses. So let's see the mass of it. There's a 43 kilogram cone, fairing nose cone. Well, we don't need it to be that big. Okay, well, they're fairing pieces and fairing base. So fairings are complicated. Fairings have a fairing base. Okay, so let's see what the stats are. Well, yeah, the top is 91 kilograms, this is 50 kilograms, and that has substantially reduced our delta V from 7, overall delta V from 7 to 6.18 kilometers per second. So, we probably want a smaller one. It's not looking wonderful. But then again, for a lunar rocket, if we gotta compare it to rockets of yore, it might not be too bad. It's not too expensive either. We're getting 6.58. So I don't know if we've unlocked maneuver nodes yet, or if they're even locked in the beginning at all. That's another question. We're just at 10 meters right now, so we can use the same pad. 6.61. That makes me feel a little bit better. Three stages. Oh, we do have gas generator engines now, though. We could really upgrade this instead of using the... But gas generator engines might be very expensive. We're using pressure fed right now. Oh yeah, gas generator... See, that's why they gave us the 50 million. but then again, this is really powerful and has a lot of chamber pressure and everything. Let's go back to the pressure fed. And we had 282 and we wanted 6 kilonewtons out of it. 6 kilonewtons. So gas generator, we're getting 172 kilonewtons, so we just want it much smaller. A gas generator engine that's 6 kilonewtons is probably... I don't even know if we can get it that small. We can. 105k. Let me undo. And this one's 35k. I don't think the ISP of the 105k one was much better, so we'll stick to pressure fed up there. Where we probably need the gas generator is right at the bottom. Look at this tiny little guy. I still think this is probably more economical and its ISP is not gonna hurt too much. Okay, so yeah, basically at the bottom. Each of these is 48k. And at sea level they only get 190. And altogether we needed, well, we'll just put one and size it appropriately and see what we can do. We are at sea level here. Is it better to downsize or reduce chamber pressure? So let's see. 201 kilonewtons here at 65%. We're getting 201 kilonewtons. Now, chamber pressure also affects ISP, but we'll ignore that for now. We are basically at $1 million. Let me just drop that down all the way. It seems like reducing chamber pressure is more expensive. We are at 1.1 million here, and it's 196 kilonewtons and worse ISP. So we get better ISP at the high chamber pressure and small rocket size, engine size. Yeah, see, we get higher ISP as opposed to the lower chamber pressure. Yeah, the mass is also lighter this way, as it probably ought to be. Okay, nozzles, Bravo. Well, I guess Bravo's okay, sounds good to me. But we are a little bit big. And we are tall, too. We don't, I'm just gonna go for Bell nozzle, because Bravo might be nice and all, but it doesn't give me all the options. And then there's actually a third variable. There's this size, and then the throat size is also capable of changing the thrust. And let's go to vacuum to compare things. We're nearly back at 7 kilometers per second. But we are going to shorten this up a little bit. Stage 2 really looks iffy. It's not providing that much. Wonder what happens if we just remove it. 9.99 meters, but we're not getting as much delta V. But our thrust weight ratio, starting thrust weight ratio, is really high. 6.77, and we've skipped the second stage. Both of the stages get about 3.4-ish. Well, the second stage is a little bit low, considering it's got a higher ISP. You can make the engine a little bit bigger. Definitely worth it. 6.89 kilometers per second. And stage 1 starts out at sea level with 1.53. Stage 2 starts out in vacuum, 0.89, which is still not bad for an upper stage. And yeah, so we can skip this stage now, thanks to the gas generator engine. 716k is more expensive, but we've got a lot. Oh, we're still a little bit tall, though. We'll make it a little bit shorter. It's a very stout rocket, though. But that's because of the pad limits. The pad doesn't limit width as much as it limits height. I think it's like 3 meters width, right? Let me check. Oh, let's just double-check staging to make sure. Fairing base. I don't want the fairing base to go just yet. Okay, and it's not really a Goblin Solid motor, but yeah, it's 3 meters in width, so you can end up with pretty fat rockets lifting off the pad. I'm not entirely sure about the aerodynamics of that, but yeah. So we will tend to launch fat rockets off of the village pad, I think. Alipad, of course, has better max size, but it's so expensive. And I don't think we need it for this one. We'll see. Certainly, we have plenty of funds to check things out. So we are here again. Be in Luna's SOI. Alright. So, throttle up. And... activate. I do sort of like launching from a mountainous area. Very scenic and everything. We are definitely past the speed of sound. Boop, boop. Sometimes when I'm looking at things, I accidentally control the rocket a little bit off. Okay, we're going pretty high now. Let's see if it can pitch down more aggressively here. I've been getting a feel for the stabilization system. I think I've got a handle on it now. Every stabilization system is different. So I have to get a sense of it. So that... oops, not the right thing. So this lock heading is on. But yeah, now that I've gotten a feel for it, I think I can work with it. Now, of course, we've got that little circle on the nav ball to show its tolerances, but you still need to get a feel for it. Okay, I think we can just throttle up here. And staging. Now, we are actually at a higher inclination launch site. So we should have probably lined up with the orbit of Luna in order to transfer there. But I know how to figure it out. Even if we don't have the maneuver nodes, I know how to figure it out. Okay. And shut down. 89.7 by 82. So, and can we target Luna? There's a plus here. Input slider. Oh, that's another way of controlling things. But again, joystick. So, okay, well, not too sure how to target Luna, so I'll do it what you might say is the old-fashioned way. The blue line is our track. And so we get it in line so that our track is in a single plane. And then we get Luna in a single plane, if I can. But it gives you an idea that over here is where we want to encounter Luna. So we want to do the burn on the opposite side. Oh, it doesn't look like I can add the maneuver, can I? It has a plus, but clicking on it does not seem to do the thing. Okay. I'll have to check the tech tree, but it'll be more interesting for me if I just do it randomly. it's fine. We'll do the burn over here, extend out to this side, and we're gonna... well, actually, Luna's over here, so we should do the burn over here and extend out to that side. It'll take less time. Yeah, and then we'll try to encounter it over there. This is an off-plane transfer. But in order to do an off-plane transfer, you actually have to go past a little bit and come back in order to wait for the arrival of your target. So again, if you do need to eyeball it, you need to get... see, here our orbit is askew, but Luna's orbit, if I got really in line, it will be in line. But if we rotate this way a bit, you see our orbit line is getting in line. And once it's in line and Luna's orbit is in line, you can see where they cross. We're maybe a little bit late on this burn. We should have done it a little bit earlier. Okay, well, yeah, I don't know. Let's leave it there. But we actually wanted to encounter Luna on this part, not that part. So we might have to wait a bit. And our battery might not hold out in that time. Well, we'll at least get some altitude record, I suppose. We have 787 meters per second left, so we could make orbit around Luna. I could also do a mid-course adjustment, but it's tough to know how to do that. I might have enough to flatten our orbit with respect to Luna, so that we can hit over on that side. Probably just want to do that at Apoapsis instead of mid-course. You can see, as we're on the slow part of our orbit, it's catching up. So that's why we want to hit over on this side. So here we were crossing. Let's go south. I don't even know if it's going to show me an encounter if I get one. Gotta lift our orbit completely so that we're very slow with respect to Luna. Come on, Luna. No, we're too low here. Okay, how's our battery life? 35%. We're not gonna do it on this one, I don't think. But how much delta V? 341. Oh, wait, I just saw something. Oh, it's gonna be too late, but we got it. I wonder if it requires us to have battery power on our vessel in order for it to count. It's something. Let's see. We're all the way out here. We didn't actually get any new altitude records, I don't think. Or maybe because I was in map view, I didn't see. For it to resume its program. Well, it's fine. Is that really an encounter? I think so. Doop. Okay, well, it gave me the completed tier 1 of Brigo flybys. Oh, is this Brigo? Did I look at the wrong thing? Oh, Luna's the further one, is it? There's three of them. I aimed for the wrong one. I didn't know about Brigo. I thought Luna would be the inner one. Okay, this is a Brigo. Well, shoot. Hello, Brigo. Okay, we aimed for the wrong moon. I didn't check. I thought this was Luna. Brigo is the one that looks like Jupiter. Okay. We got to 274 kilometers over Brigo, but unfortunately that's the nighttime side, so we wouldn't get very good pictures. Okay, but I have learned an important thing, which is we don't have the maneuver node system. So we should probably get that. And I'll try to be more careful about the transfer next time. So we just need to aim for Luna. I think we had enough for a flyby. We just need to extend out further. Is this Luna? How do I tell if this is Luna? Seriously though. I guess there is the... let me just end flight. Save flight, yeah. Okay, so here we have Brigo. Okay, Brigo, Luna. Luna is here. So Luna is the second one. And then TT. Okay. So, I didn't have any qualms about the rocket per se. Do we have extra batteries, just in case? Down here, static electricity. We've got battery. And it's wheel torque, but that's not important right now. Solar panel. So, static electricity and rapid charge we need. So we need 80. Too bad we didn't get many tech points for passing by Brigo, huh? Plan maneuvers, 70. Okay, so we need to get plan maneuvers over here. Okay, but it did show the encounter with Brigo. We've got plenty of money. Let's just go. We got plenty of money. Let's just, I mean, we're basically at the limit of the pad anyway, so. Of course, considering the cost of the rocket, $128,000 for the big pad isn't that bad either. Okay, switch craft. Okay, tracking this one. Alright, second moon. Throttle up and launch. In the case of Earth's moon is actually tilted as well. It's not equatorial. So with Earth's moon from Cape Canaveral, you can get a situation where you can launch directly into its orbit. Okay, staging. A little bit of a higher orbit this time. Okay, 107 by, let's say, 85. So 107 by 85. And let's see how it all lines up. So, not that one. This one. It's tougher to eyeball it from this far out. We'll just sort of get the moon in line first. That looks about right. They are, the moon and Brigo are tilted with respect to another just a bit here. Okay, so we should burn from that side. Maybe we'll get here in time. I don't know if the orbital speed of Luna is so fast that we won't get here in time. Okay, let's try it here. It's bound to be a bit off. Nope, that's paused. Currently, we have 2 kilometers per second. Come on, Luna encounter. Oh, we got it. I'll take what we're getting right there for now and then adjust. After all, we can't really see what the periapsis is. Oh, see, I'm worried about that. Okay, let's just see what it is there. I trust that that's an encounter. Okay, departing Droo. We have 746 meters per second left. Luna has a much bigger sphere of influence, so it's easier to get captured by it. Or pass by it, clearly, than Brigo. Okay. It says apoapsis NA, periapsis NA. This is not nice. Can't you tell me? Okay, well, I want to get closer, so. And we have the... Oh, maybe it's paused, that's why. No? Radial in. That looks like the right idea to me. We'll need to judge from this view. Oh, there it is giving me the number. Okay. 3,800. Maybe we were right on the edge or something. Okay, that's close enough for me. They have an ordered orbit. But I might as well demonstrate orbit. We could crash into the surface and dispose of it, though. An impactor, like Ranger 7. I'm just thankful I don't have to worry about communications. communications makes things a lot more complicated. Especially around the moon, where you're going to be out of line of sight for half of it. Okay, round here. Retrograde, please. Don't know exactly what the size of Luna is, but I'm thinking this is going to be enough delta V for capture. Oh, sorry, I was on 1/4. I was on 1/4 time. I always go to pause a 1/4 time without knowing it. Okay, so we actually made Luna orbit. Hopefully that doesn't mess up the contracts, and I will dispose of it. So we're going to go to apoapsis. We are going to not be paused and ignite. Crash into the surface on the daylight side. Hopefully facing Droo. Yes, ideal for science to impact on the side facing Droo. And here we go. And daylight. Daylight's important too. Let's see the camera views here. Space aligned, default, space aligned. Okay. Space aligned. And you are chase view, flyby cinematic. Okay. Flyby stationary. Okay. No camera parts. Okay, so custom cameras. Well, I guess one thing we can do is a slow motion demise at 1/4 speed. And we landed! Shh. Well, something exploded, but I think it all died, but because we can't focus on it anymore. But it counted as a landing, so okay. All right. Well, we landed on the moon, sort of, kind of. In flight. Safe flight for sure. $2 million. Okay, I keep saying this, but now we're rolling in dough. What are they going to give us to do now? Brigo flyby, really? Well, I mean, we might as well knock it out, right? How? So we actually took 4.1 days so far. So far, the career mode has taken that much time. So we can still do these things after a little while. Yeah, I'm sorry to do something repeatedly, but we might as well. We got a lot of tech points though, so maybe we can unlock maneuver nodes this time, and then we can make it different like that. Gantt charts. Fine. Alright, so we've got maneuver nodes, and we should get batteries. Okay, but we can't get the solar panels just yet. Okay, otherwise, we're just going with the same rocket, just going to use maneuver nodes. So, to Brigo we go. Throttle up, and launch. Right now, this is sort of a downsized Delta rocket, you know, with pressure-fed hypergolic. I mean, it's actually mob propellant here, but I'm just gonna pretend that means hypergolic. Upper stage, and then we've got Kerolox gas generator lower stage. Thor, but yeah, sort of like a Delta rocket or a Thor rocket. Maybe more like a Thor, just because of its stoutness, feels like a Thor. But it's much smaller, of course. But then again, capability-wise, it's not too bad. Okay, staging. 4 days. Okay, so that's a running timer of days as well. I was clicking it to see if I could change it to our flight time. It looks like it's saying that the total elapsed time in the save is 4 days and 2 hours and 29 minutes. And that's what it's counting. And I suppose that would be local hours? I don't know. Because I haven't seen it have too high an hour count. Okay, oh, we're going a little bit out of whack here. I allow the vertical speed to get too high. Hubris. Okay, alright, but here we are, 167 by 80.9. And right, so sure there's a way of targeting things, but that eludes me right now. That's not ideal, but don't know exactly how I want to touch that up. Map options. Burn gizmo sensitivity. You know what? Maybe I should just take what I've got there. Something's happening. And we're just really hoping that because we're getting all the way out here, Luna doesn't interfere with it. But we'll do this. And I don't think I see the burn information here. Flight info. I know that if we have tab, he'll have the maneuver, but... And on the nav ball, it's that purple marker thing. Okay. Well, I'll just split the difference on the arrival time. Okay, right around here. Let me turn again. Oh, I paused it. Turn again, and ignition. What is it maneuvering now? I hope it's not too confused. It seems to be like if we did the maneuver again or something. I don't know what it's doing. Hopefully... Whatever. Whatever. I'll just feel it out. It's fine. It's fine. Okay, now I'm worried. Because we were supposed to get a little encounter. Okay, I don't want that flashy line. Okay, just junk that. We have 780 meters per second to work with. I should have seen the exact apoapsis that the plan had on it. But okay, we'll work this out. So, yes, not super good with the maneuver node system. Looking at it from this view, I should have probably pushed it out a little bit further. Let me see here. Let's go a little bit north. And a little bit up, so northeast. We've obviously not got an encounter though. Crossing really close. We don't have enough juice, and we were too early. Now we're just sort of hoping for a random encounter. Oh, this one. It's dodgy. It's dodgy, I know, but you know, it's allowed. Here we go. And we had already done that Brigo flyby anyway. Okay, 756 kilometer periapsis. How is it still controlling it? We are out of battery. It shouldn't actually be able to turn it. Right? Well, let's see. Yeah, I can't turn it. But apparently it can, without battery, still turn to... Well, it turned to this orientation. But maybe they can't do anything more. Brigo should be... Partially in the... there it is. Okay. Once again, passing by Brigo. But this time we got paid for it. Alright. And so with that... And this will end up crashing into the surface, right? So it will be disposed of. In flight, safe flight, save and exit. Alright, so we've done 3 flybys of moons, actually 1 orbit and 1 sort of landing. Now we've got a Brigo orbit contract here. And we've also got another Brigo flyby. I guess we could probably pack those two in. And maybe we could upgrade to a rocket that actually needs the better pad. I don't know if it's necessary for these contracts yet. We'll see. So anyway, with that, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.